Welcome back mga kamatlets! It's me again, Teacher Robert. Our topic in this video is all about organizing data in a frequency distribution table. In this video, you will learn how to organize data collected. You will learn also on how to construct frequency table in both ungrouped and grouped data. The word data refers to information that is collected and recorded. It can be in the form of numbers, words, measurements, and much more. So let's begin with the definition of what is an ungrouped data and grouped data. Ungrouped data, which is also known as raw data that has not been placed in any group or category after collection. Then, group data is the type of data which is classified into groups after collection. So, after gathering data, we need to organize them. If we don't do this, we might miss important information about the data and may result to difficulty in interpreting the data that we have gathered. So, kinahanglan, after we collect the data, in our previous video, we have the collection of data. So, after we collect, so we have to organize them. Kaya kung ato din na ito i-organize, basin o ma-miss na ito ang mga information sa mga data, unda maka resulta hinoon ni sa maglisod ta pag-interpret sa data nga ito na gather. So, using frequency table helps us to record, clarify, and easily find that what we are looking for our data. So, in a tally table, tally mark, kanangawan 1, Roman numeral 1, are used to record data, while in frequency table, numbers are used instead of tally marks. So, frequency, what is this frequency? Frequency is the number of occurrences of a data. Butasabot, kapila siya, nagpakita, or pila kabuok. Muna yung frequency. Frequency table is a table that lists items and shows the number of times the item occur. Muna siya table, from the word table, it is, nagod siya, row and column. Oh, diha makita kung unsa itong mga category or mga score, then tally mark o frequency. Itong frequency. So, steps on constructing a frequency table for ungrouped data. So, step 1, make 3 columns. Maghimok ang 3 columns, then arrange the data in order in the first column. Then, make a tally. Then, count the tallies, then write the frequency. Then, total all the frequencies. Totalo ni mo, pila to kabuok. So, primero, maghimo ka og table or tulo ka column. Then, i-arrange ni mo ang mga data in order. But, masabot in order, it could be ascending or descending order. Ascending, kung gikan sa ubos, or gikan sa lowest to highest. Descending, kung gikan ka sa highest, paingon sa lowest. No? Then make a tally. Putpasabot ka na bang magtali-tali o may kahon. O kanang may nga na ba? Muna'y tally. Isod sa kahon. Muna'y tally. No? Then ihap kung pila, count the tallies. Ang ipon ang pila kabuok nung imong gi tally. Then, motos the frequency. Now, for example, 40 kabuok to kabagit, 40 ang frequency. Then, total all the frequencies, totalo ng tanan mga frequencies. For example, below are the results of a survey about the favorite colors of 15 students in a freshman class. So, what colors the most favorite of the student and the least favorite color? Kana siya, there are 15 students, unsa gigamit nag-survey sila kung unsay mga favorite color o sa mga estudyante, no? Favorite color sa mga estudyante. So, money sa tubag sa mga estudyante, lain-lahi. Okay. So, first step 1, maghimo tag tulo ka kolom. Its column sa first column is color, second tally ang ikatulo frequency. Then sa first column under sa color, ibutang nato ang color. Na kay wa man in order nila. Busabot bisan kani mo, wala na dyan. Unang green, red, yellow, violet, white, and black. Tapos total. Tapos after that step 2, magtali-tali na ka, ipuni mo pila ka green. For example sa green, ihap ka usa, duha, tulo. So wala, wala yung green. Then sa red na po ka. Red, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4, there are 4. So sa yellow, yellow na po ka. Yellow, 1, 2, 3. Then violet, 1. So inga na imong himuon, 1. Then same as white and black. So yep. Oh, kana. So pag tutalon himo na ka frequency, siyempre ipunin mo kung pila katali. So sa green, sa green dunay tulo, red 4, yellow 3, violet 1, white 2, black 2. Then after that you are going to total all the frequencies. Tutalo ni mo 15, di ba? Kinahanglan ang frequency, ang total frequency mo, musibo kung pila ka buok ang imong respondent. 15 student ba to? So 15, kinahanglan ang total frequency 15. Kaya kung dili na sila mag-coincide, na there's something with your tally. Na is something sa imong tally. There's something sa imong pag-ihap. Okay. Next! Kay mao na siya solution based on the table, di ba na question kung unsay pinaka unsa nga color ang pinaka mas favorite, most favorite o na yung pinaka less favorite color. So based on the table it shows, so interpretation ta, it shows that red is the most favorite color, di ba? Why? Ngano man? Siya may pinakadaghan. Pinakadako. So red is the most favorite color and violet is the least favorite color of the 15 students. Okay. Moto si Jay paghimo sa ungroup data. The other example is in your module. So by the way, this is a module 3. Ano, module 2 in your sa quarter 4 sa mathematics 7. Steps in constructing a frequency table for a given ungrouped data to be transformed as group data. For example, there are given ungrouped data, no? And you are going to transform that one into group data. So, that first, you are going to determine the range. Range. Range is the difference between the highest value and the lowest value in the set of data. First, you are going to determine unsay pinakadako nga value. For example, sa score, pinakadako nga score o pinaka gamay. So highest and lowest the value. Imo nang i-minus, highest minus lowest, mao nay range, no? Mao nay range. Mao nang natay formula R or range is equal to H minus L, that is highest minus lowest. Second, determine the desired number of class interval or categories. Determine, no? I-determine nimo ikaw magbuot og unsay class interval nimo or pila ka kategori. Pero ang ideal number is between 5 and 15. So pwede sa 5, pinakataas ang 15. Ideal na siya sa class interval, number of class interval. Okay. Step 3, determine the class width. Class width or approximate size, class size. Class width or class size, manager. Of the class interval by dividing the range by the desired number of class interval. Nanakay range, di ba? Nanakay range. In step 1, you determine the range already. Sa step 2, you have the class interval. Imo nang i-divide range divided by class interval, maunay class width or class size, maunay mo resolve sa class size or class width. Class width or class size mo ra. Okay. We have step 4. Write the class intervals starting with the lowest value as determined in the data. So, maghimo ka o class interval, kinahanglan sugod sa pinaka-ubos nga value sa given data. So, then, gikan ana, mag-plus ka o i-plus ni mo, gikan anang lowest, mag-plus ka kung pilay imong class width. No? Add the class width to the starting point to get the next interval. Then, step 5, tally the corresponding number of score in each interval kung asa siya na belong. Then summarize the result or sum up the tallies under the frequency column. For example, kana siya, the following are the test scores of students. Construct a suitable frequency table. So use 6 as the desired number of class interval. We have already the class interval 6 kuno ang atong class interval. So step 1, determine the range. So the highest in that given score, given data, is the highest score is 40 and the lowest is 10. Okay, tanawa. Oh. Ang pinakataas diha, pinakadako is 40, ang pinakaubos is 10. Nakuha. Pero mas maadyo kung imong i-arrange in order para dili maglibog. 40 minus 10, the range is 30. We have our range, 30. Then step 2, the class interval is 6. Ang atong interval is 6, di ba given sa problem? 6, kinahanglan 6 kuno atong gamiton. Okay. So, then step 3, ang atong class width or class size, we have 30 divided by 6 is 5. Ang atong class size or class width is 5. Okay. Then write the class interval starting with the lowest low value as determined in the data. So, ang atong lowest value is 10 man. So, mag-class 5 ta. So, therefore, the class interval as are 10 to 15. 10 to 15. So, gikan kang 10, paingon kang 15. Tapos, ang nagsunod nga class interval or category, 16 na po magsugod, paingon kang 21. Then, 22 to 27, 28 to 33, 34 to 39, 40 to 45. So, okay. Next is tally. Kung nga ni ang pagkabutang, 10, pwede ang 10 to 15 sa babaw, pwede po sa ubos. As I've said, it could be ascending order or descending order. Kining atong gigamit is ascending order. Ascending siya kay pataas. Pataas gikan sa pinakaubos, paingon sa dako nga score. Nakuha? Okay. 10 to 15, 16 to 21, 22 to 27, 28 to 33, 34 to 39, then 40 to 45. Diba? As I've kaganina, 140 ra ang highest score na to. Don't mind the one kaning pinakadako. As long as magsugod tas pinakagamay. Ito ha? Okay. 10 minus 5, 10 plus 5 is 15. Mo no, 10 to 15. Okay. Next tally. Itali ni mo kung pilay mo pila ka score ang bilong sa interval nga 10 to 15. 10 to 15. So, ihap po na to. So, ang atong tally na ha is dunay na po. There are 10 scores that is belong to the class interval 10 to 15. 10. So, na po ang tally na kabuok. Then, isuwat ni mo ang frequency. Kuha. Ay 10 man na siya. So, doon na siya ay 10 nga frequency. Then, sa class interval nga 16 to 21, ang scores, there are 9. 9 ang tally niya, 9. So, 9 ang atong frequency. So, inga naon pag himo. 22 to 27, upat, counta, 22, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, yes. 3, 4. So, there are 4. So, 4. Pagkatali nga naon ninyo pagpangita kung pila ka box score ang musod ana nga class interval, given class interval 28 gikan score ko no nga 28 or 33 pila ka buok. Diyan na imo pangitaon, diri na nimo pangitaon. Same as the remaining score, tapos ibutang ang frequency, tapos after that you are going to total or sum up all the frequency. The total is 35. So there are 35 students, no? 35 students. That's all. Thank you. So, and once again, good day everyone.